Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we got a graph here set up for us already. It's trying to show us the relationship between the temperature in degrees Celsius versus the time underneath right here, which is in minute, okay? It looks like a very straight, single straight line. So guess what? If you see a straight line, it means you're looking at a y equals y, mx plus b graph, okay? Now remember, the y is your y-axis. So in this case, I'm going to put down the degrees Celsius right there in the position of the y. The m, if you don't remember what m is, it's the slope of the graph, okay? So we're going to figure out the slope later. And the x, so let me draw a box for the slope. And the x is the x-axis. So it's in the time, and we just use the variable t. But just remember, it's in terms of a minute for this question. Now the b is known as the y-intercept on the graph. The y-intercept is where the graph would touch the y-axis. If I just kind of look at the graph right here, if it kept going straight down like this, it will probably enter the zero, go across the zero. So in this question here, you don't have a b for your equation, okay? Just leave it out. But the problem is, how do you figure out the slope? Well, remember, you might want to learn it right now. The slope is equal to the rise over run, okay? It's basically how the graph behaves, going up first and turn left or right. Now, this is how we do it. You can pick two points. Let's say I pick these two points right here. Now just ask yourself, how can I go from here to here? Well, if I just using the rise over run, which is the slope, which is the m over here, okay? All we have to do is just think about that. In order for me to go from here to here, I need to go up 20 units first, okay? So this is 20, this is 40, so the difference is that I need to go up 20. So the rise in this case will be 20, and it's positive. Why? Because you're going up. If you're going down, it'll be negative, okay? Then, in order for me to go from this point to here, I need to travel from 2 minutes to 4 minutes. That's a difference of 2 minutes. So that means I need to go to my right side 2 minutes. So it's positive because you're going toward the right, okay? And if you're going towards the left, it's negative, okay? So 20 over 2, what do you get? You don't need a calculator for that. At least for me, I don't need one. 10, okay? So the 10 is actually your slope, which is represented by the m in the equation. So guess what goes in here? 10t, okay? So the relationship between the degree Celsius right here versus the time is just that the degree, the temperature, it's equal to 10 times the t. That's it. So the equation here, the equation for the relationship, is right over here. You can either use this one right here, or feel free to go y equals to 10 times the x. You can also use this equation, okay? Well, where did it go? Y equals to 10 times the x, okay? So that way, it's easier, all right? But if you want to use the variables from the question, then it will be degrees Celsius equals to 10 times the t. All right, let's check out the next.